what is the pattern that is very clear to you here? There's a pattern here, as opposed to the chorded one, jo maine kal dikhai diya. There's a pattern here. Obviously, the first thing is that this is the nerve center here, the busy point. Yahan tak theek hai. That's why it's called putamen circuit, because putamen is the main area receiving, sending, etc., etc. Right? So that's one thing. Any other pattern that you are seeing? Look at the inputs. Inputs in this diagram look like the dot and then the line arrow and then the direction of the arrow. So the dot is origin, arrow is where it's going. With that, tell me, there is a pattern here. Where are the inputs coming from? So, premotor, motor, somatosensory. Somatosensory, kaun bola? Yes, good. So it has a good coverage. This I'm telling you, because when you look at the chordate, you will see this has limited coverage. This has a wider coverage, sort of. So you see that the origins, things that are coming, it's receiving the information, it's from a wider area of the hemisphere. Yes? So that's one part. Number two, all of this is, of course, converging to putamen, because it's a putamen circuit. Then look at what putamen is distributing into. Look there closely. Try to remember this. Because I don't know when is the next time you'll see this diagram, but in your personal time. So I'll use this time to facilitate your learning. Look at where the putamen is dishing it out. Which are the main areas? You see the globus pallidus. Yes, very important, by the way. Then you see some stuff going to the subthalamic nucleus. Then third, the substantia nigra that I spoke about, and so on, right? Then to complete this whole thing, look at where the efferents are going. They haven't used the word efferents though, i.e. the signals that come from the basal ganglia back to the brain. Where are they going? Does that make sense to you? It should make sense to you. Why would you want a basal ganglia output to motor areas? You would, because basal ganglia is to do with execution of complex movements. That's why you gave it a bunch of data, which was diverse, including somatosensory data, and what you were thinking about the motor movement, premotor and motor. You gave it all this data, and what did you want? You wanted a good qualified suggestion of how to do this movement. So the thought came from wherever it came from prefrontal cortex or frontal cortex. It goes to pre-motor areas, then motor area, then basal ganglia, gets processed over there, brakes are applied somewhere the acceleration is applied, and so on and so forth. The whole thing is matched with previous information, and then whatever is appropriate, that set of motor plan is sent back to the motor cortex for onward transmission. Yes? It's pretty straightforward. I have just explained the English that we used yesterday. Executing complex movements. How? This is how. This is the pathway of information. And this is pretty much what we know right now. We don't know exactly, well, at least in this, at the level of the undergrad, you don't need to know what happens, what should happen in the putamen or inside the globus pallidus and so on and so forth. What you do need to remember is which neurotransmitters are involved, and we'll show you that those neurotransmitters. Whoa, that is very crucial information. The neurotransmitters that are involved in this whole circuit, very important, because some are stimulatory, some are inhibitory, and guess what? When you will look at the diseases, you will actually solve this as a puzzle. That okay, if the excitatory is missing or the inhibitory is overdoing its stuff, then this should happen. And then match it with the text. So it's like a sort of a mathematical thing. If you understand who is doing what, you don't need to cram the whole thing there. You can literally work it out. We'll do that in a bit. So this is that. Any questions about Beautiful? We did all of this in Pictorial. If you want a reminder, that is another lecture. The guy, the Afro, that guy, the shouting guy. Okay? So virtually all skilled movements are down to the Beautiful circuit. These are the lesions. I'm sorry, this is not the color that is in my computer. Somehow transmitting it over email changes colors. Can you see this?
Yes.
Text nazar aa raha? Okay. This is just a one-line list of the stuff that can go wrong in the putamen circuit or the basal ganglia as a whole. Globus pallidus can stop working. The issue is called athetosis. You can look it up. Simply, it's spontaneous writhing. Continuous writhing movements like this. Okay, any good video on YouTube can tell you, can show you these movements. Okay, due to again IT limitations, I did not integrate the videos here.
Right.
Maybe so they will appear in the
online one. The slides show the audio. Instead of your video, we show only your
face. Okay, can you tell them that inshallah they will have the lecture?
Both slides already given, and I can move the
change. I'm not changing around. So you can tell them, if they can hear my voice, that they need to turn to the lesion slide. Enough to just tell them, okay, now put up the next slide. They have the slides, I believe. They don't? The ones overseas? Do they have the slides? Or email to them straight away. Maybe email them? This would be a wrong process. Okay, so note to Abdullah, could you remind me of making the slides available to you before the lecture so that you can send them the slides as well? So they can just, you know, अभी चलने देते हैं वरना फिर बहुत लंबा काम होता है और अभी इसको मैक्सिमाइज कर देते हैं. ओके, जस्ट लेट देम नो. ओके, वेयर वाज आई? एथेटोसिस एंड सिमिलरली सबथैलेमिक न्यूक्लियाई लीजंस आर कॉल्ड हेमिमेरिस्मस. यू कैन लुक इट अप. प्यूटमन, यू कैन लुक इट अप. कोरियाज अवे, स्लाइट मूवमेंट्स ऑफ द बॉडी, फ्लिकरिंग मूवमेंट्स. दिस द रेड स्टफ इज द मेन थिंग व्हिच यू हैव टू नो. So a student who does not know this stuff is allowed to live. But if you don't know Parkinson's, that's supremely uncool. Okay, so Parkinson's you need to know. Okay, Parkinson's is a disease of the substantia nigra, and the neurotransmitter involved is dopamine. Dopamine is an inhibitory neurotransmitter. This is the first time I've said it. I will keep on repeating it till the end of this lecture. So as you remember, the dopamine inhibits stuff. Remember when I spoke about the basal ganglia, I was introducing it. I told you that basal ganglia deals in inhibitions. Not too much excitement, but morally inhibition. So something wants to just fling over that side. You want to control the mood. That's basal ganglia. Basal ganglia controls this urge of the nervous system to go into overdrive. And I mentioned this before. This is that grand inhibitory wise guy that sits in the background. So and it uses dopamine. The dopamine is that neurotransmitter, which is the inhibition of the inhibitor. Okay? This is called it. Now work it out. This pattern is different. Tell me. Take a few seconds. Look at this diagram. This diagram, tell me what there's a clear difference here. Come on. Let's have the inputs first. Hurry up. Tell me the inputs. Ek beta bachcha bol le. Ji bete. Yes.
Sir,
okay. So it the input too is from a more wider area. Okay. However, look at the output. Do you see a lot of similarity in the regions where the input is coming from and the output is going to? No. No. This is something that I want you to think about. Cognition. Do some cognition on. Yes? What is happening here? So the data is given widely. This, by the way, what is this lobe dealing with? Occipital lobe? Any? You have read this in FSC somehow. A level, certainly. Occipital lobe? Vision? Vision? Occipital lobe, vision, right? What about this here? This we will read, we will study this. This area houses a pretty important area which integrates a lot of sensory stuff. Okay? So it gets its information, it's getting its information. Remember, it's cognition. Please keep that in mind. So the circuit is getting its information from the visual, obviously. Yes, remember the line. You're seeing the line, right? You know that it's a line because of the sensory, memory, shemory, everything integrated in this part of the brain, the seat of learning, vagara, vagara. So you know it's a line. You know, okay, it's not good for me. The line is open. And I'm open too. Okay, I'm here, and I'm vulnerable, not him. Okay? Then the input is obviously from the motor areas, which need to now sort it, do something about it. What is this? Where is this coming from? Frontal or prefrontal cortex? What does that do? I've mentioned it yesterday. Thoughts.
Intelligence.
What to do with what? You know, all the analysis that you do, the detailed analysis. There is an analysis called prognostication, predictive analysis. So these shares, which are not allowed, by the way, but these shares, the prediction that this company did that company and it's going to happen like this and that in the future. They actually call it futures market. So they predict the future. All this analysis, not just stocks, gave you a bad example there, but all the analysis, political analysis or intellectual stuff, everything sits here. This is your intelligence, okay? Or the lack of it. Come on. This is it's me, you, a joke has to fly. Although I think the joke is really that the sense of humor has gone down of this class. Maybe you guys are smiling and I can't see you. Maybe, I don't know. Okay. So this area is closest to the cognitive areas. Now look at the output is simple. The output is all going towards the frontal cortex, telling it, go, run, leg it, whatever. Okay? Because the line has approached. Okay, now we've done all of this, the input and the output. Now let's check this out, this whole thing here. Interestingly, immediately you can see that the subthalamic nuclei are not being disturbed here, neither the substantia nigra. So that's an important point. So you can immediately draw a conclusion here. For Parkinson's. Again, I want everything linked to Parkinson's because you need to know Parkinson's. So Parkinson's is a substantia nigra problem. Yes? Caudate circuit does not involve substantia nigra. So that should be intact in the fellow. However, what goes is all the stuff that he can do with in terms of complex movements. So check this out. What if the Parkinson's person sees a line? This is an important question. I've just made it up. It's actually a good question. Hold on. Are you guys with the program? What if the Parkinson's person, patient, sees the line? He or she would, mostly he, would understand what the issue is. Yeah?
Yes.
It's a line and it's struck. But what can I do about it? All the suggestions are going through the quarter circuit. Hey, Akhruj, Viraj, let's go, come on. But the putamen is not there. You see, you understand now?
Yes.
The two circuits, this is the issue. No. Questions? When you have a question, just raise the hand and block the lecture. You have that right. I'll just move forward. Okay. This is very simple. I will just do this. Abhi ye wala area aayega isme. Ye aa raha hai? Ye nahi aa raha. Okay.
Isko yahan pe lana padega.
Nahi bas ye kitega. Now imagine that I want to write a letter. Okay, let's use Guyton's language. I want to write the alphabet A. Small A. It goes like this, right? Small A. I can write it like this. I can write it like this. Why am I not facing you guys? I was pretending there was a board. Why is this open? See the issues of stereotyping in the brain. The brain has stereotyping in it. So it's the scale of movement and it's the speed of movement. Like the mic guy yesterday. He took his time. You can do it. This is all basal ganglia. The scale of movement, big, small, the velocity, the speed, quick, slow. Basal ganglia. This is another function of the basal ganglia. Guyton has tucked it in a separate paragraph for some reason, but you should know today that this is part of the functions of basal ganglia. So, very mundane, boring questions come in professional examinations. Really hope nobody from UHS is watching this. And they ask you the almost the FSC style or your high school type of questions. They will ask you functions of basal ganglia. What are you going to do? You have to write something, right? So, complex movements, talk about a bit what putamen circuit does, talk about what the caudate does, and then talk about, please don't leave this out because it does not fit in any circuit. He's just mentioned it separately. Okay, so enough caution to you. So scale, timing and scaling of movements is very important. Any questions? This is where it becomes quite interesting now in this lecture. The PPC, the posterior parietal cortex. Right here. This is the parietal cortex, the posterior side of it. On both sides. Here and here. Yes? You are comfortable with the anatomy? Right here and right here. Okay. This is the PPC, a very peculiar area. Very interesting, fascinating. And peculiar. So right now, my PPC is telling me in a sort of GPS way where I am standing. I'm aware of my surroundings. I know what's, I can't see, but I know, I'm aware what's behind me, what's laterally here, of course in front. Even if I close my eyes, I can still feel you guys disturbing you. Because I know you are here. Even if I were placed here with my eyes closed, I would have some sense of people in front of me. This is why it's very interesting. How does this place work it out? I have a nickname for it. It's our GPS. What it does is it has all the motor coordinates, like in a GPS, location coordinates. It has the motor coordinates of the entire body. So imagine, if you will, it has a GPS map, don't write it anywhere, just it's an understanding, of all the coordinates of the motor stuff you can do. It is aware. It doesn't do anything directly. It's just aware of them. It's a sensory super area. Sensory super area. Yes? And it's extremely important for this area to work. If you want the motor system to work, and in the few seconds you will understand what I have just said, the sensory to motor transformation cannot happen without the PPC. So it does something with this sensory data, this awareness, blah, 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 coordinates, etc., etc., that it's essential for motor activity. Without this, something remarkable happens. I'll tell you. So if the right PPC is damaged, you have, it's a contralateral thing. So left is controlling right, right is controlling left. You will lose track of what? You will lose track of your left side wale, the list of motor assets. Yeah? The right will be intact because the left PPC is intact. So this is the left PPC. It has all the maps of the right side of the motor coordinates. And so has the right one for the left. So if I damage the right PPC, the body will literally not know what resides on the left side of the body. We call it neglect syndrome. Personal neglect syndrome. This chap, although it's not funny at all, it's a very serious issue. This chap will ignore that side of the body as if it did not exist. From this, we understand what the PPC does. With PPC, we are aware of ourselves, the motor cells, not philosophical stuff, right? So he would put only the right side of his jacket on and the rest of the clothes. He needs to be told, ke bhai, wo left. And then he will realize, and then he has to look at the left hand to realize he has a left hand. See how Twilight Zone-y stuff this is? Yes? He would shave on half side of the face. It's true.
But does the visual input from the other eye stop too?
The visual helps him. But there is a serious trouble because you are not looking at yourself in a full size mirror all the time when you're changing clothes. I hope you don't do that. So yani, it's a very strange situation. He would tend to ignore it. I'm not saying in a certain rendition of this syndrome, he actually discovers every time he looks at his left side of the. Not always. But in a certain type of this syndrome, he actually finds it surprising that, oh, who is this? Oh, it's me. And then obviously memory works. So he has to recall his memory to remember the left side of the body. So interesting enough. This is the PPC. This is how the PPC links with basal ganglia. Do you know why we have discussed the book discusses, and I made it a point to discuss with you, the PPC in basal ganglia, because basal ganglia is that the place where all the complex movements reside. It can't do anything if you don't give it the motor assets. It's like a toolbox. If you don't know what to do with it or where to use them, what good is a toolbox? So basal ganglia is intact, but PPC isn't. So the coordinates are gone. So all that you had stored was complex movements, but where? It's just half of it. You are aware of just half of them, of all the things. So most of the complex activity cannot happen. Hence it's linked to basal ganglia. Do you understand this? I think this part is difficult. How does PPC, why am I teaching PPC in basal ganglia? Jee.
In this case, sensory input will not be incorporated.
Sensory information nahi jayegi because you have damaged it. This is the problem. The sensory to motor transformation ka maine mention kiya tha na. So sensory information is not reaching PPC, it's reaching your cortex wagara wagara. We are only talking about PPC. And you will, when we'll do Cortex, I think, please do remind me somebody to mention this when we are looking at Cortex in the next chapter. Over there, PPC will again come, but in a, as a very foot point. But do remind me to talk about personal neglect syndrome there as well. Okay? So the sensory to motor transformation happens in PPC. That's why we mention it in basal ganglia, and certainly we will mention it in the cortex as well. Okay. So this is just the wordings of what I've just said. Awareness of surroundings, your motor assets, etc., location, segment, body segments, etc. This is a nice thing. Reference frame. So PPC, there's a reference frame of the body and its surroundings sitting in the PPC. It's literally like a GPS. Pretty cool. Disorders are failure of sensory to motor transformation, agnosia, which is inability to accurately perceive objects through sensing them, because PPC is damaged. And then one part of agnosia is the personal neglect syndrome, which I just described. Some data. This is from a patient who is ignoring his left side. This was the case that I described. The one who has a problem with right PPC, he will tend to ignore the left side. So if you ask him to draw a clock or a plant or whatever, he will tend to not give attention to the left side of the whole thing. And a fully developed right side, as is clear here. Okay? So this was shown to the patient, this is what he drew. This was shown to the patient, this is what he drew. Okay? I have addition. This all of this is personal neglect syndrome. Okay? This will be part of the video and the slide, so you can go over them as you like. This is the reference for this part of the lecture with some additions. ACH is acetylcholine. So the purpose of this diagram is just to show you, this is from Guyton's, very good diagram. This is just to show you the currency which is used in basal ganglia. Ji bete.
Sir, we have
your brain behind. This one
take
the right PPC. Well, you can see
that you have to take your body's left side.
Visual field bhi aata hai. Visual field bhi aata hai. Yes. It depends on the extent of the PPC damage. If it's fully damaged, then the whole left side is gone. Then he will need to be reminded, what I was saying, he needs to be reminded that left side of the body exists. So visual field also comes at the left side. Yes? Yes, no? Aap se pooch raha hoon. Okay. Right. So this shows you the neurotransmitters. Okay? As you can see, acetylcholine is released from the cortex and acts on certain parts of the basal ganglia. Lock that in. This will come in the next 10 minutes. Look at the role of acetylcholine, where it is getting secreted. Just lock that in, okay? Then you see GABA. GABA coming from the basal ganglia towards the substantia nigra. Very important second component, second part that you need to remember. GABA is a neurotransmitter, okay? It's inhibitory. It's coming from basal ganglia, various portions to the substantia nigra. Okay? Third thing. One is acetylcholine. Second is GABA. Third is obviously dopamine. So dopamine goes from substantia nigra and inhibits the basal ganglia, the ones before it, putamen, globus pallidus, etc., etc. Yes? I beg your pardon, caudate and putamen. It inhibits caudate and putamen. Yes? Again, link it with your knowledge, whatever right now knowledge is, of Parkinson's. In Parkinson's, what would you expect to happen looking at this diagram? I want to complete the jigsaw of Parkinson's today, hopefully, inshallah. So, up until now, you know a good half of how to figure out what Parkinson's is. We have said it relates to substantia nigra. Now we have put in dopamine. Now we know where does dopamine go from where? क्वेश्चन
क्वेश्चन के मैं ये करना चाह रहा हूँ कि पार्किंसन में सब सेंसरी निग्रह काम नहीं कर रहा, तो डोपामिन प्रोडक्शन कम हो, फिर डोपामिन नहीं एक्ट करेगा ग्लूटामेट को क्राउडेड न्यूक्लियस में, जिसकी वजह से वो जो इनहिबिशन कराते हैं मूवमेंट्स की, वो इनहिबिशन मजीद पड़ गए हैं।
इसी बात, वेरी गुड, दिस इज एग्जैक्टली द पॉइंट। So, once again, in substantia nigra, there are dopamine-secreting neurons that get damaged by Parkinson's. So now we are increasing the jigsaw pieces. Now you know exactly what happens in Parkinson's, yes? So there are neurons sitting inside the substantia nigra that secrete dopamine. Those get damaged by Parkinson's. You have a dopamine deficiency in Parkinson's, right? Now, just follow the arrows of dopamine. Look what they're doing. I'll come to you. They are going back to the putamen caudate, and since I mentioned that it's inhibitory in nature, it will inhibit the caudate and putamen, which, by the way, is in a super excited situation. Why? It's literally sitting under cortex and getting a lot of positive stuff from the cortex. Okay? Because pehle aapne movement to karani hai. Movement will come from caudate and putamen. So they need to be excited. However, it's too much. To inhibit that, you have the dopamine pathway continuously keeping a check on them. Ji Noor?
Sir, jo
good, thank you. That means you have remembered that slide. Good. Now, this is a simplified diagram. That also was a simplified diagram. It can't show you everything. It will be impossible to read for an undergrad, first time, who's looking at this first time, and not scare. There are so many pathways here. Remember the Guyton diagram that I showed you yesterday with a lot of arrows? Imagine adding a lot of arrows to those arrows. When you're looking at neurotransmitters, it becomes very confusing. But there is a pathway from substantia nigra to caudate, the reverse pathway. He was probably in that diagram, he was concentrating on the forward stuff, not the backward stuff. And this, mind you, is not a pathway which involves the cortex. It's the intra-basal ganglion connection within the basal ganglion. So this is the slide to look at. Secondly, it does not mention glutamate. Isme glutamate nahi hai. Dher sari glutamate pathways exist in basal ganglia. But probably he hasn't shown just exactly for the confusion thing. It will confuse you. So a lot of glutamate is coming in this direction, which is excitatory. This is something that I want you to note. He mentions it in the paragraph. Should have mentioned it in the diagram. So a lot of glutamate is secreted in the basal ganglia, which is excitatory. It's not all inhibition, by the way. Obviously, something needs to be excited. That's glutamate. So what do you expect in basal ganglia, Parkinson's, when you now have the knowledge what dopamine does and where it goes? So the check and balance on the excitation of the putamen and the caudate will be removed. So now whatever they do to the all those suggestions and whatever, remember the river that I mentioned about, the input of the basal ganglia will be predominantly excitatory. Not inhibitory, excitatory.
It will be excited.
Yes.
To become more inhibitory for the muscles of the body.
No, Acha. This is where the confusion lies.
I learned it.
So and this is a good confusion to have. The kids are getting confused about what happens to the muscle. Will it get inhibited or will it get excited? It becomes rigid with over excitation. How's that? And that's a very sweet spot of the lecture. So we have done spasticity in the first lecture, the first muscle spindle wala lecture. We have mentioned spasticity over there. Now we are mentioning rigidity. Same thing? Similar thing, certainly. spasm is so it leads to rigidity of the muscle. Rigidity, English wala. But now we have a medical term of rigidity as well. There is a confusion which I forecasted it. But just hang on for a few minutes. I will address it. It's in the slide. Ye ho gaya. So at least you know that when dopamine goes, putamen, caudate, the basal ganglia, they are free to launch an excitation drive. This bit should be clear. Is this clear?
Yes.
There is no, the major inhibitory pathway that has gone out. Okay, so over excitation. Now start. It's a question. Obviously Parkinson's. The reason to give famous personalities before is so that you remember that all of these guys had. Hitler too had Parkinson's. Interesting. Now this is the face. This is his youthful face. This is when it started. The timeline that I mentioned yesterday. And this is his advanced Parkinson's when he became quite old. And I think when he passed away, he had a similar effect. The really last interviews that he had. With Muhammad Ali, by the way. I hope everybody recognizes this guy. Very animated person. And he had Parkinson's. It's a degenerative disorder of basal ganglia, depletion of dopamine. Causes of that depletion, some sort of degeneration of the whole neuronal pathway sitting inside the substantia nigra, may have a genetic component to it as well. Some antipsychotic drugs cause Parkinson's. They have to be given, but a side effect is the whole Parkinson's disease. This Northern California drug dealer was inventing the perfect drug, not as in medicine, drug as in drugs, okay? And this idiot accidentally mixed certain chemicals which gave a good, very good high to his customers, but also gave them Parkinson's. They damaged the dopamine secreting in a longer run. And he was actually caught by police because they traced back all these cases of Parkinson's in even the younger lot coming from a certain area of California. He said, what is going on? Why are young people getting Parkinson's? They followed the track and got to this Einstein here. Okay, severe carbon monoxide poisoning somehow can also damage the substantia nigra. Now what happens and this is where you guys will be happy. Spasticity versus rigidity, I've already decided that it needs to be dealt with in a separate video, a short one, where I will just talk about these two things. This will help you in your clinical years a lot as well, because this is a confusion which you don't get confused in second year, you get confused in your clinical years. Because this word spasticity and rigidity in English both means rigid muscles, but have a totally different technology behind them. Okay? Anyhow. So we know the tremor of Parkinson's, I hope you remember from those times when you used to meet on the screen, the tremor of cerebellum versus the tremor of basal ganglia. I hate these times when I have assumed something that you would know and then I see this.
Voluntary
tremor? Yes, intention building. Yes, voluntary or intention. Cerebellum, intention. You intend for something to happen before everything is fine. Peace is there. But when you go for something, it starts to tremble. This is cerebellum. Intention tremor. Basal ganglia tremor, tremor all the time. Continuous tremor. Yaad kar lo ya. Fayda ho. This is a viva question. Tremor of cerebellum, intention tremor is with movement. Resting tremor is in basal ganglia. Continuous resting tremor. Okay? When you see a Parkinson's patient, or when you see a video of Parkinson's, you won't forget it. It is so graphical, you'll remember it. And I encourage you to look at some videos of Parkinson's patients. Text can only give you so much. You will need to see it. Now, the big topic of sort of today and maybe that video is rigidity. The rigidity of Parkinson's is because of the dopamine deficiency and overexcitation of the basal ganglia. What it does is it overexcites the muscles so much that they can't do anything. They're just rigid with overexcitation, and you can't move them because they are fixed now. They are overexcited and fixed. They're not overexcited, and what do you want from them? You have increased their muscle tone so much that they can't do anything now. All the muscle spindles, bagara stuff, it has sort of been banished. You have bombarded this muscle or these muscles with overstimulation. Okay? That is rigidity, and it's called lead pipe rigidity. You know the lead pipes used for water transmission? They're not flexible. They're lead, steel. So when you try to flex the arm of a Parkinson's patient, okay, you will feel the tension or difficulty throughout the range of motion. This is called range of motion. All of this, it's a clinical term, range of motion. So this is the range of motion at the elbow. So you will feel resistance flexing it, resistance extending it, both. This is called lead pipe rigidity. Yeah, okay.
लेकिन सर बेसल गैंग्लिया ओवरस्टिमुलेट कैसे करेगा? आपका तो फंक्शन ही इनहिबिट नहीं होता.
सर बिकॉज ऑफ डोपामाइन. इट्स बिकॉज ऑफ डोपामाइन. आई हैव केप्ट ऑन सेइंग दैट इट हैज टू एक्साइट बिकॉज इट इज द सजेस्टर ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स मूवमेंट्स. सो देयर आर एक्साइटेटरी फोर्सेस इन देयर एज वेल, बट प्रीडोमिनेंटली इट्स इनहिबिटरी. बट यू हैव टेकन आउट द मेजर प्लग आउट ऑफ इनहिबिशन, डोपामाइन. So what is left? Excitation. Yes, Abdullah?
Yes, without dopamine, basal ganglia is excitatory function.
Yes. Is the rigidity clear? These are very pet questions, and these are pet questions for the good students, and I don't want them to mess it up. So the rigidity of basal ganglia is lead type fixed rigidity. Please hammer this in. Then there is a, if this is clear, I have to move forward. There's a cog wheel. What is a cog wheel? That wheel of the ready ke wheels nahi hote. There's no other way of saying it. Cog wheel. So English mein usko cog wheel kehte hain. Okay? What is it? It's sometimes it's fast and sometimes slow, sometimes fast, sometimes slow, because it's uneven. Have we seen a ready before? I have this sinking idea that probably some of you are, they haven't seen a ready before. So note to yourself is watch a video for it. That is a cog wheel. Okay? Now in some cases of Parkinson's, what you have is, what I've just demonstrated is resistance on flexion, resistance on the whole range of motion is one difficult maneuver. A variation is cog wheel. So a variation is this. This is also Parkinson's, but it's a variation. It's a new, it's a different variant. And it's just lead, I'm going to say this sentence now. It's just lead pipe rigidity with the tremor. Cog wheel rigidity is lead pipe rigidity with the tremor, superimposed in some patients. Generally, you will find lead pipe. In some, you will find cognitive. Okay? Last mic, yeah?
Yes.
It's about the one, yes. It's about the connector. So, this is in contradiction to clasp knife. Kitni badi contradiction hai. Lead pipe, clasp knife. Clasp knife is a different technology, different thing. And we studied it in. ये बता दो हमने पढ़ा कहाँ था ये. Where did we study it? The rest of the class. Where did you? This is where the 60 and the 70 come forward. The 60, 70 students that at least appeared on the street. We don't know how many of them were awake. Let's find out today. I taught it. I repeated it because it's my habit to repeat. So go on. Where did you read this phrase? Clasp knife rigidly. I'll give you a hint. It's related to a reflex. Clonus ke aaspaas padha tha. Okay, chalo. But which reflex did you read it under? We read it under. Clasp knife. Kisne kaha hai? Who said Golgi tendon? Golgi tendon. Good. You read it under Golgi tendon. I taught it under Golgi tendon. It's an important distinction. Okay. Let's see how much is left. Okay. Bradykinesia. Movements are slow. Everything about a movement. Think of a movement. Think this. Movement. Walking movement. Then I took a turn. Came back. Parkinson's person can't do it. Parkinson's person will take baby steps. He has to be very tentative. He will most probably look at where he's going because the whole thing is rigid. Okay? He has to pick himself, place it like this, pick himself, place it like this, and special issue comes when he wants to turn. When you want to turn, we turn like this. It's very easy. But imagine how this guy would turn. So he will take all that, both those baby steps, first will turn at it on his axis, right? And then move in the other direction. So turning is a big issue. Walking in baby steps is an issue. While walking, he can't stride, very small shuffling gait. Posture, stooped to maintain his center of gravity. So he can't stand straight because of the rigidity. He'll be slightly slumped over. Most of them, old age, they fall backwards because of loss of those writing reflexes that we talked about in the vestibular apparatus. The writing reflexes, not the writing reflexes. Dhakka diya, piche gire. Those things are missing as well, okay, because of the rigidity of anti-gravity muscles. So frequent falls in the backward direction also happens in these people. Masked face, we've talked about expressionless masked face. One of the first things that you can see, literally when the patient walks in, is the face. You can tell, probably Parkinson. Okay? Throat, all the muscles are rigid, so this person will have drooling of saliva from the side of the mouth because he can't swallow properly. Okay? The production of saliva is obviously constant. So the mouth will fill up and then the drooling will stop. Speech is very slurred. If it's not advanced, in advance it just stops. The moment that he actually stopped talking, he couldn't talk. He didn't stop talking, he couldn't talk. But initially, they have a very slurred speech, very slow, tentative, monotonous, PTV mein khabar name wali speech. Very mundane, no expression. Advanced mein dementia aa jata hai, memory loss hai, frequent falls. Psychiatric disorders, how come? So all the thinking brain is intact, check this out. This person whose body is now rigid, but the entire brain is working. He has all his ideas, all his ambitions, all his memories. What to do about them? Can't move. Then they usually become depressed and aggressive and so on and so forth. This is a picture to just reinforce what we have just said. Just go through it. It's very descriptive. Have we left anything? No? Go to questions? Okay. I've really gone into detail, but in Guyton it's very simple. He has given pharmacological treatment, medicines. Remember those medicines. They are mostly synthetic dopamine.
L-dopa.
Okay. Mostly they are dopamine or their surrogates, or inhibitors of the enzymes that break down dopamine. Always think of this when you're thinking of pharmacology. In medication, You either increase the production by giving the thing, or you conserve the breakdown. Decrease the breakdown so the availability is more, breakdown is less. Okay? Just like you did with myasthenia gravis. When you were looking at the acetylcholine, okay, you inhibited the acetylcholine esterase so that there is more acetylcholine. Same thing is here. Okay? However, there is a surgery. So they remove part of the thalamus to break the circuit of the basal ganglia. In patients who are very advanced and who have very poor life, so they do require some surgery. So they literally remove part of the brain to break the circuit of the basal ganglia so that it doesn't work. And hence the rigidity is relieved a bit. A bit. It doesn't treat them. And it's not a obviously a the go-to thing. It's a last resort kind of thing. Huntington's is the last point. It also is mentioned here. And usually the good ones are asked about. Most of you will be asked about Parkinson's. Some of you will be asked about Huntington's chorea or disease. It is a similar disease, however, the culprit is a GABA. Remember GABA? GABA and acetylcholine. They go in this disorder. You have all sorts of flickering movements, then they become whole body movements. And one other point is they have severe dementia at the start of the disorder, not at the end. In Parkinson's, it comes at the end. In this one, it's really in the start. Sure. You've done this.